explain the COINS standard. It's an exchange standard for BIM data, GIS data, systems engineering data.
It's currently applied in a couple of projects at Rijkswaterstaat. And it's been, well, developed, I think, 10 years ago, but currently it's, well, getting more and more traction, I guess. So I guess the first question is, what is COINS? Well, it's an open BIM standard, and it really focuses on exchanging data. Obviously, we already have BIM data to exchange, but if you look at a whole project, then we also know and realize that there is GIS data to be exchanged, but also documents, of course, and Excel sheets, but also, especially in the civil engineering industry, there is this systems engineering data, which is getting more and more present and available. And if you want to work together, COINS believes that we need to exchange, well, all that data, and preferably model-based, and preferably in one container, if you like. Thinking about such a system, exchange protocol, or data format, or whatever you like to call it, then COINS also thinks about managing these kind of data sets, if you like. So they've also specified a building information system, which is just a specification, how to handle all those COINS containers. So why COINS? Well, one of the ideas is that if you're a client of the civil engineering construction industry, then you want to engage a contractor, and you might want to include information delivery specifications, how the contractor will deliver its information about the object, the civil engineering object, that's going to be constructed. And COINS is currently an information delivery standard, if you like, for Rijkswaterstaat. So Rijkswaterstaat has a couple of projects where they signed a contract with a contractor, of course, and within that contract there was this information delivery protocol, and they say, well, you will please exchange data via the COINS standard. So it can be used for information delivery specifications, if you like, but the real question is, why would you want to do that? Well, if you get that information, all the information, systems engineering data, BIM data, GIS data, then you can start thinking from a client perspective about what is going to be realized, so I can check if my design is valid to the requirements we have. Obviously, it's also for asset management, if you like. If you are Rijkswaterstaat, for example, or ProRail, or another large organization with a lot of assets, and you're building new things, then it would be ideal, nirvana, I guess, to have all the data that you get as build data, perhaps, or even the whole design process in a container, in an information exchange format, and directly put it into an asset management system. COINS tries to, go that direction, if you like. So reuse of information from design to asset management, and it's model-based. I guess we don't have to explain that. It's not Word documents, but it's model-based. Computer can interpret it, and hopefully it can process it in such a way that we can directly use it without too much human intervention. So how does it work? Conceptually, I guess, as the previous speaker already mentioned about this multi-standard world and a world where we need to think about, semantics, but also layering the semantics from international to national level or perhaps company-specific level. And we see a lot of, initiatives in that area. We see that objects of interest are being described in the computer interpretable manner. Taxonomies are made, specialization hierarchy are made, properties are defined, relations between those objects are defined, and that's becoming a vocabulary, if you like, to start thinking about interoperability between a lot of systems. And COINS has the same vision in that way that it sees GIS data, it sees BIM data, and it sees that all that elements or entities within that in that data is going to be referenced to those vocabularies, if you like. So we'll have a lantern post or street light defined in a semantic library, and we'll have CAT systems that will refer to that object in that library so that we know explicitly what we're talking about. And that's for CAT, for GIS, but also for systems engineering data. And they're all tied together in one container, if you like, for exchange. So how does it work from a technical point of view? Well, the most simplistic version is it's a zip file with a predefined directory structure, and it has in the directory structure there's a documents directory where you can put in all the documents you want. So that's, I guess, very easy. So we've got even Revit files, IFC files, GML files, etc. The more complicated part, I guess, is that there is also a BIM directory which contains, well, a model-based information model tying everything together. And that's based on semantic web technology, OWL, to be more precise. And that model is, again, based on a COINS core model. So what is that COINS core model? Basically, it's on one hand a very simplistic model. It contains some systems engineering constructs, like we have functions and we've got function fulfillers. We need light as a requirement, and a street light is a function fulfiller for that. So we divide up the whole world in requirements and, well, physical objects, solutions, if you like. We've got a model for that based on OWL. So we've got objects, we've got hierarchy, we've got cardinality restrictions, we've got those triples, we've got those very granular way of storing information so that we can, well, process it in a very advanced way. We've got interrelationships between objects. They are not further specified, but you can, because semantic web allows you to easily define a relationship further in your own way. So you can basically define whatever you want. COINS deals with library parts, and also COINS has this vision that those semantic libraries I talked about, the vocabularies, the taxonomies, that they are being developed, but there are multiple standards in that area as well. So COINS tries to harmonize those standards by basically converting it to their own COINS product library standard, if you like. And there was this linking between objects within the COINS core model and geometry IDs, if you like, in GIS and IFC, which is a first level of integration between those two, I guess. So we've got ourselves our COINS container, as it's called, the zip file with all the documents and the OWL model based upon the COINS core model. The COINS core model can be extended via regular semantic web technology, so you can, well, make specializations of objects in the COINS core model and use them if you want. And each object in the COINS container refers to, well, a vocabulary, an external one. So, and then we've got, well, basically a reference system, if you like, specifying all the information that's in the documents directory via the COINS core model towards, well, external semantic libraries, object type libraries. This is in Dutch, but this is just an example to give you an idea of such a, well, library. So here it is, the lichtmast, the street light, and that's an external system which defines and describes what it is exactly. And COINS refers GIS objects or BIM objects towards this library. So how about geometry? Again, this is just by linking, so the easy way, I guess, not full integration, but we can specify a street light, we can identify it that is available in this Revit file, and it uses this unique ID that is present in the Revit file as well. So we have a simple unique ID matching between the model, the Coinch Core model, and an IFC file, and we can do the same thing for GIS. So there is no real integration between the two data sets, but it's a very pragmatic way of at least specifying where you can find, well, the object. So, geometry file formats integration, no. But we can refer to anything we want. But there's also a relative placing going on. So, for example, you can specify in the Coinch Core model, you can say, well, there is a GIS file. It specifies the whole surrounding, if you like. And based upon that coordinate system, I can specify my BIM model within that system. And there's even an implementation of that, visualizing both data sets, simply in Nevis Works, where you use the coordinates in the Coinch container to have relative placing of those two data sets. The last thing is the Coinch building information system. So if we look at the process of collaborating, exchanging, well, Coinch containers between clients and contractor, but also between contractors and subcontractors, or even internally, then there's also a specification how to manage these kind of Coinch containers. You can imagine, especially in a concurrent engineering approach, that you want to set out a lot of Coinch containers containing requirements, and you're asking your contractors to come up with a design for that, or a sub-design for a certain part. And you set out all these Coinch containers, and at a certain point of time, they will come back. And then we've got the Coinch building information system, which tries to, well, gather all the Coinch containers and tries to merge at least the Coinch objects in the Coinch core model of the container, and storing all the 3D information and 2D information as documents. So what's the status right now? Currently, a couple of projects has used the Coinch standard, so that's pretty good. More projects are in the pipeline, if you like. They are coming because they are in the contracts. So it feels like Coinch is, well, coming up, if you like. Tooling is really in a first generation of the tooling, so I guess Coinch is really in a tooling phase right now, where we are making prototypes of Coinch tools that are already there and try to professionalize them into a more mature tooling environment so that we can have a broader audience to work with Coinch containers and the Coinch data exchange format. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Hans. Who is using it now? There are some projects, but who are the users? You can use that microphone there.
Rijkswaterstaat is definitely pushing it right now, but it is a standard, so it's broader than that. But it feels like that Rijkswaterstaat is really using it now and consequently developing at least the software ecosystem. The Schiphol Almere Amsterdam project, a big road project in the Netherlands, they are delivering. A couple of projects within that project are delivering Coinch containers.
It's all in the Netherlands, not internationally yet.
I'm not too sure about that, but I think it's definitely focusing on the Netherlands right now. But it is an international standard, and it's going through an ISO process as we speak.
Okay. Yeah. And there's lots of tooling available for IFC, free of charge available. Is that the same with coins, or are you going to charge any users?
Well, it's an exchange format, so the specifications can be found on the internet, and everybody is free to implement it and do whatever what they want with it. And in a certain way, we hope to have commercial parties to deliver this software ecosystem, and that's definitely the phase we're in. There are a couple of tools which are developed by TNO, which are open source or at least free available, and there are a couple of commercial tools available as well.
Okay. It's you can find it on this website.
On coinsweb.nl is a nice entry for.
Okay. Are there questions for Hans from the audience? Oh, lots. Shall I walk with my microphone to you, or you can use this microphone? That's what Sarah says.
Yes. Can you hear me, Hans?
Yes.
We've heard a lot of material from our client in this master. We've heard a lot of information about coins, yes, that's already. And a lot of information about.
Thank you. And we have a lot of information about Vigon by Bart. Personally, I would like to see the Vigon as the future coins. Yeah. That's solving some issues that we encounter now, that we are learning, like software support, like internationalization, pure use of semantic web technology, etc., etc. I would like to hear your view on this interrelationship between current coins and future Vigon, maybe.
Well, I know a little bit about Vigon, of course, but not the details. So I only have a broad view on that. Conceptually, I guess I would wonder where the coins building information system and the Vigon solution, it feels like the coins building information system is a necessity because the focus on coins was on exchanging data and you need to manage that, so you come up with a coins building information server. And Vigon really focuses on operational management, asset management from that point of view. But it feels like perhaps that those two worlds can easily come together. Very similar technology, very similar ideas. Does that answer your question?
Well, partly, and I agree what you said. So, okay, great, thank you.
Okay, there was one more question, and that's the last one. So,
of ours, but I'm looking for a way to incorporate the data we get via coins containers back into our asset management systems. Do you expect the vendors of these asset management systems to integrate support for coins containers in the future? To directly to use the information back into those asset management systems?
Yes and no. yes, I hope so, at least. But the no part is because I think coins is the most important part of coins is the coins core model, which is semantic web technology. And I think one of the power of semantic web is that it stores information in such a granular way that it is quite easy to convert your data into another scheme and into anything else. And the power behind semantic web is so big that I envision that a lot of systems will have some kind of input for semantic web data. And it really tries to make the mapping easy. That doesn't mean that mapping becomes easy, but at least there is no technology problems anymore. It becomes more a conceptual mapping problem, if you like. And I think in that scenario, which is not there, which is not here yet, but in the future, I think the mapping between a coins model and a Vigon solution, which might be based on a different, slightly different schema, or your asset management systems, will be quite easily to realize, because semantic web really gives you the power to map those kind of models. So I think the problem will be solved in a very easy way.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. There are more questions, but sorry, we don't have time for them. Thank you, Hans. And now there's only one man in between this time and the coffee. So it's a hard job now for Herman Oging He's CTO of Nemetschek SIA, and he's involved in BIM Plus, a new initiative, and we are going to hear more from him.